Platinum 2 right now. I don't play those.
Legend 2. Legend 1. Before the day's up, trust me. Also, I'm going to need the Vagabond.
I switch tags.
Anyway.
Who's the most wholesome man that you guys know?
Me.
No, it's Masahiro Sakurai.
Masahiro Sakurai.
I mean, just look at this picture. Just look at this picture.
Hold on, let me move my...
Oh, look at him. He's so sweet. He's happy. Mm. He's showing off. He's
I like, could tell he wanted an orange character.
He definitely seemed passionate about it.
He did.
I'm telling you, I've never seen him. I mean, I've seen it, but it's just funny as hell that he just, as he was talking about arms, reached, didn't even acknowledge it, reached behind his pillow, had a spring there. My first thought was, what else does he have behind those pillows?
Me too.
His setup, though. Neil was talking about it earlier. His setup is fucking unreal.
Yeah.
So, that's the first thing I got under here is, welcome to the ArenaCast. We're going to talk about Min Min.
Yes.
Because she's a Smash character.
I've totally seen the whole Min Min presentation.
You did. So, first of all, we're going to do an overview only because I have to get to this part. The presentation overview, Sakurai's setup is absolutely amazing.
Yes.
He also addressed what's going on in the world perfectly.
He kind of, if anything, he was just like, I'm staying at home.
Real quick, but like, imagine if we just spent like the whole video talking about everything except Min Min. Like, we're talking about, yes, like, his setup is amazing, great person.
I hope you know this first half an hour is going to be nothing about Min Min.
You said it's a 45-minute video.
That's right. You did say that.
Anyway, Min Min's cool. I like the dragon one. The ball's going to be good in compilations. But can we appreciate that Sakurai's house looks really
nice?
Did you see his hairstyle, man? Come on. You're mixing it up all the time.
He's living his best life. He's trying to live his life. He's trying to do his thing. And he's an amazing man.
He's an amazing gamer.
We have to, just before we do anything, because there's a lot that us Smash fans like want in Smash Brothers. But there are a lot of people, I think, especially now. And I think that there are more people. Well, what I mean to say is, I think there are more people now that appreciate what Sakurai has done in the Smash community over any time ever.
Yeah.
There are still half the fan base that is just like, if Sora's not in, then fuck this guy.
Did you see the people who tried to say Nintendo's racist because they picked Min Min?
Yeah. So Resetera, right? The one about the new stuff is like, you should have picked Twintail because that's whatever.
All I have to say is
do not argue about arms if you do not care about arms. It is the stupidest thing.
No, forget that. The fact...
No, hold on. I'm not done.
Okay.
You didn't play arms. You didn't have Twintail to win. It is absolutely stupid. Twintail didn't win the popularity contest. Min Min did. Twintail isn't the producer's favorite. Min Min is. Relax. Calm down. What were you going to say?
No, I'm just like, it shouldn't matter what they play. Like, the fact that you would call someone racist because they didn't pick the black person is insane. That doesn't make any sense.
I understand what's going on in the world. But can we appreciate how wholesome both Sakurai and Min Min are?
Min Min was very...
That shit is insulting.
Come on, please.
Anyways, and we... And all of us agree, by the way. I'm pretty sure that... Like, we do have a problem here about Black Lives Matter.
Absolutely. Like, that's...
It is an injustice about what's been going on in the world for years.
But to call someone racist for a reason like
but
that...
But to do something asinine like this is beyond me.
People just... Smash fans just can't be happy. Someone's always got to find something to complain about.
I'm probably going to cut out every single part of this bit other than Min Min's wholesome.
Min Min is wholesome.
Min Min is wholesome. Anyways, so now I can just cut that part.
She's sweet.
Anyways.
I love her a lot. Like, the whole
ramen
thing.
So let's talk about this trailer.
The Nintendo ramen.
So let's talk about this trailer. So first of all, before we get into the big points about this trailer, let's talk about Cap. Because Cap did a fantastic job in this whole entire trailer.
That's right.
About drinking ramen.
That was hilarious.
Drinking, yeah. Like, I love that, like, he was like, yo, he hasn't come back to the recording booth in, like, 20 years, but now, for this, he's back.
And
like,
did you know they were, the fact that they were planning final smashes, and we found that here.
Yeah, it's
crazy.
Wait, what happened? I didn't actually watch it.
They were planning final smashes since the beginning of the game.
Yeah, since 64, they wanted to do what was essentially final smash.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, there was two iterations after that they were able to do it.
So... So Kirby there was great. Captain Falcon, especially for the end, was great.
I thought it was hilarious how Kirby just
the bowl
and
table.
Min
oh,
just,
I
love that
He's
Min
so
Min was
cute.
Just standing there. And then let's see, is there anything
the
else?
Was so good.
It was. Dude,
so first of all,
terrible.
After seeing that, you knew it was gonna be Min Min.
Yeah.
The minute I saw him drinking ramen, I was like, of course.
Yeah.
Then,
also, she was like, she's too popular to show the big yellow one first. I'm like, oh. Also, what really tipped me off is because I forgot the presentation was happening, so I opened my phone, and it was Min Min, Min Min, Min Min. I went, oh, well, duh.
Yeah, that's all we talked about during when we were talking about it. Like a few months ago. So, then we go to the stadium, and... When I saw that, I'm like, so are we gonna get, like, a multi-character? Like, is what I would wish I could think, but no, I thought... I always thought it was Min Min, and then the sheer fear inside of me.
When Springman picked it up.
When Springman saw it and picked it up, I was like, no. No, this is gonna... They're not gonna do this. Springman and Waluigi are gonna be there. And then all of a sudden... So this is how I envisioned this. Sakurai was just like, we should make it Spring Man, maybe.
Didn't Sakurai say
no, hold on.
Oh, okay.
Hold on, I just wanna say this scenario.
Yeah.
I keep hearing all of these, he was gonna pick Moon in, so he's just like, what if we have Spring Man pick it up and seem like he's actually gonna get it? And he's just like, why would you do that? And he's just like, because I'm putting my foot down. I'm saying no Maggie. To these ungrateful children that want Waluigi and Smash Brothers. Yes.
I agree with you, but what does no Meggies
mean? Yeah.
It just means no. It's just Twitch chat lingo. People say no Meggies.
What started no Meggies? You're taking more words to say no.
That's just a casual way of saying it.
Like, I've heard, like, Pog Champ, Poggers. Many,
Fog
but
you.
Never heard that one.
Yupcock. That's
yeah,
how I
heard
got it
Yupcock from you.
Because I know, like, Sakurai said, like, he was considering Min Min or,
Ninjara.
Yeah, that guy.
So the thing is that it was never going to be, first of all, and I say this, the people that want Waluigi are the redheaded stepchildren that we have to let in. That we have to let in.
This is becoming Kyle's.
They are
Hold on.
Yeah. They are ungrateful children.
You wrote it down.
And just hold on. Just be like the Isaac fans and be depressed.
And be depressed.
These hot takes. I love
hold on.
Them.
Hold on. Isaac fans, just be depressed. I'm a Skull Kid fan and I want him in Smash. I'm just depressed. I don't go out there and make a billion memes. I don't tweet Sakurai angry rants.
Well, I mean, it's Smash.
No, but the problem is that, like, the Waluigi fan base has been so cancerous about it.
Well, Waluigi's cancer.
Honestly, like, what else are Smash fans good at other than, you know, definitely not Smash Brothers? Like, what else? I don't know.
But it's just stupid.
I mean, it's annoying that they complain.
Yeah.
Like, there's good complaining, or, you know, good, like, asks. Like, I don't remember people foaming at the mouth being like, where's K. Rool, you fucks? It was just like, they should put K. Rool in. He'd be a cool character. Then
like
Ultimate
Banjo,
happened, and then suddenly everyone
suddenly,
went from, like, oh, it would be cool if they went into the, if they're not in, you're just not a good developer mentality.
Like, what?
Like, that's what the Waluigi fanbase has become, and it's stupid. Like, people have been, like Geno's been wanted for such a long time that people have been just like, okay, you guys all need, you Geno fans need to stop. But it's just like, no.
Someone told the Geno fans, enough's enough.
Enough's enough.
Right.
And then this happens. So we go into the trailer. I have to segue into it. We go into the trailer. It looks like Ribbon Girl's gonna pick it up, but she's a Mii costume. She ain't doing that. So Ninjara picks it. By the way, you have to love that Sakurai only lets the people that touch it, or the people that either got a Mii costume or were an assist trophy.
I actually didn't think about that.
That is pretty clever.
I thought about that earlier. I think it was yesterday. I thought it was interesting because I keep watching this trailer. It is probably my favorite trailer. I love it. Anyways, and then Min Min picks it up, and as we know, Min Min, I believe, is a 3-star spirit in Ultimate.
Mm-hmm. I'll take your word for it.
I don't remember. It might be a 2-star. I don't know. But yeah. I'll look into this. I think it's here.
I mean, it doesn't really matter though, does
Min
it?
Min Min is a 3-star.
Was.
How did you even have that information?
Because I was
Yeah, he had that.
So I was looking up pictures for this before
I see.
We did it.
Uh-huh.
So
yeah,
that's how
that makes sense.
So
Kyle was like, I came prepared.
I have a look up pictures for this discussion. Anyways, spirits are no longer deconfirmed, and there were a billion people. This is what split the fan base. People, for the most part, were just like, assist trophies, they're not getting in. Mii costumes, for the most part, they're not getting in. Spirits, however, has divided the Smash fan base for a while, whether or not they could be in the game or not.
Are there any cool characters that are just spirits? No, I'm saying other than Geno.
Oh, okay, no.
I'm not joking about Geno. I'm saying, like, who else is a spirit and just
well,
a spirit?
Well, I want
Egg. Like,
yo,
I want Egg.
Goku's a spirit. That's, yeah.
There is a Goku spirit.
There
right.
is.
Yeah.
Not you know? Actually Son Goku.
See, you
but...
know, we don't have to say that, though.
Oh, it's Hero.
Yeah. No, it's just, like, some random... I have no idea.
So I do have a list of the five spirits I actually found that I thought would be worth that don't have Mii costumes. Because I literally had to go through the whole entire list because I forgot Rex was a Mii costume.
Yeah.
So... now we know spirits, just like how in Smash 4, because I don't know who I argued this with, because Lucas was a trophy before we even knew that DLC was even coming. We only thought Mewtwo was going to be a pre-order bonus.
Yeah.
And that was the end. And then it got data mined that Lucas got it, but that was besides the point. Point being, he got it. And that's what pretty much divided it. People were just like, oh, but it would be cool if this character got in or this character got in. And then they were just like, no, they're probably not going to get in because they're spirits. And even some important ones, or I guess important ones, because for the World of Light, it doesn't matter anymore. Because A, spirits can change their battles because of the Cuphead thing. Because that they did a lot of that in the Direct, which was...
yeah.
So that if you buy the Cuphead of Mii costume, it changes their spirit battle from Mega Man to them.
Oh, okay.
And he said that expect that in the future.
So back to the Min Min stuff.
Sorry about Min Min, because Min Min, by the way, I know my Geno bias and my Waluigi shitting
bias.
Yeah, I guess bias. Has to come in because I just think that you have to be, I don't know, just let a developer puts actual models in a game for character they don't think even has a moveset. Just be grateful that they're in, like, in general.
Yeah, don't say that to people. Don't, if you're gonna time travel, don't say that in January, because people are going to be very offended if you say that about Pylon.
No, I said just be happy that there were models incorporated for your favorite character.
Oh, that's not enough. They don't want it. Yeah, I they should be. You're right.
Wait, what do you mean models?
Like,
no, I'm talking about
this trophy.
I'm talking about Waluigi. I'm not talking about anything about Violet. I'm talking about just be grateful that your assist trophy is actually has an in-game model that can be used in the game. Yes.
I thought you were making the point, just be glad you got anything, and I was going to go, don't say that to people in January, because there were Smash fans who were going to
most
swear
people,
to God the game was horrible because Violet is in it.
Most
does Violet go to tournaments? No one goes to tournaments nowadays.
Exactly, but...
For
Violet's
the 3 weeks Violet was around, did Violet go to tournaments?
No, Violet's not good anyway. Like,
not, exactly.
Not competitively good.
Not at all. Casual.
I was going to say most people were pleased with most of the base roster, because King K, Ridley, Isabelle, as much as I don't find Isabelle to be that appealing. Castlevania. The whole characters being back, and also Banjo.
Yeah, like, I saw somewhere, like, people did, like, a comparison of, like to dislike for, like, all the DLC characters. And, like, the one, like, even, like, Violet. Like, because people didn't like Violet, they like, Min Min, and they were some of the highest likes out of all of them.
You know why? Those fans are fucking persistent for the 200 ARMS fans that
yeah,
are
apparently,
out there.
Like,
they're gonna
hold
fight
on.
To the death.
Hold on. What were you saying?
Oh, no, that was it.
Oh, I was just saying... But the thing is that, like, we expected ARMS. People could be angry about it, but, like, it was... It happened.
Mm-hmm. I mean... You
say that about any new character.
I'm saying, like...
still get mad about
that's
it.
True.
It happened.
That's true.
I don't know. I don't think we should be mad about Violet. Like, if people are still mad about Violet, you're just butthurt at this
I feel like
point.
Most people aren't. I think they're over it now.
No, there aren't.
But
it's
now
just...
we have Min Min, and people are... Oh, gee, this is so... Like, you were just, like, looking...
Oh, no, it's just my shadow on my hand.
So, like... No, but it happened, and most people were actually happy. It just wasn't Spring Man.
Yeah, but I think after they showed the character and, like, how she plays, people were like, oh, this character's actually really cool.
That's how I've seen it. Like
yeah.
There should be a really big like compared to dislike.
Yeah,
it
was like...
Min-Min's cool.
Yeah,
because,
like, people before they announced who it was, they're like, oh, fuck ARMS. But now that it's, like, this character's cool, oh, no, I like this.
So. ARMS is gonna get a lot of sales.
Yeah.
I
well, like,
don't believe
they're,
that.
They're gonna get a...
Yeah.
And they're gonna go, they're gonna, what's that? Oh, that's what...
Yeah.
But, like, the five people who have, like, nothing to do, they're like, I'm gonna buy ARMS, and they did it, and they go, wow, this sucks. I'm gonna go back to playing Smash.
The thing is that it sucks that everything else about ARMS that isn't the gameplay is literally god tier.
Yep.
The art, the characters, the tone, the music.
Only it was a good video game.
Yeah. I agree.
Right?
Everything else is really good about it.
It sucks.
Mr.
Game is not fun.
Coming for us.
Anyways.
It's a
first,
competitive game. I don't know about that one, Chief.
So she plays pretty much... She plays... I think it looks cool. She does her arms extending. You can switch her arms. She has a reflector.
Yeah.
Insane.
She, like, kicks up and then... I like that. I was like...
and in the final Smash...
It's cool.
Really good.
They all come
yeah,
out
I like that a lot too. Yeah.
It was a great cool. trailer because it wasn't exactly the Terry trailer.
It was really similar.
It was the Terry trailer.
But
yeah,
however, it wasn't exactly the Terry trailer, but it was
the Terry.
It had its own spin on the Terry trailer.
But it's
what
the
I
Terry
it's just
yes.
the Terry
There's
trailer.
No spin on it. It's just
yeah.
the Terry. Like, I guess
well, the
spin.
Thing is like, so they showed all of the different franchises for Terry, like separately, where this was all of the
but
ARMS
that's only because
together.
Because that's all they have here. Like, there's not a whole history of ARMS games.
That's true.
It's just the Terry trailer.
Right.
It's just, there's a ticket, except the differences in this one that they touch it.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's a minute thing. I'm not complaining about it.
Yeah,
I think
it's a
great
good
trailer.
Trailer. Yeah, it's just...
I even think the Terry trailer is good.
Yeah.
I don't think either of these trailers ruin the other one. But it's just the Terry trailer.
That's true.
Like, I think a cool thing, you know, like a spin on it is the invitation card. You know,
yeah.
Villagers trailer gets it in the mail.
Yeah,
Joker,
yeah.
steal the greatest treasure of all, and he turns it, and it's the card. Or Terry, you know, they go and grab it, and it's like, what's the card going to be for this time? Or, you know, Sothis throwing it to Byleth.
Yeah, I like, even from, like, Smash 4, like, the Rosalina one with, like, Rainbow Road and stuff. I thought it was pretty cool.
Because
they're all racing, and they're like, oh, it's like, oh, I like that. I don't know.
It's like, oh, Smash Care, I mean, Mario invites his fucking wife, his girlfriend's kidnapper.
Yeah, it could be anyone.
He invites Donkey Kong and Kirby.
Yeah.
Alright, wouldn't Super Smash Bros. Mario Kart be cool, though?
It would, though. It'd be so cool. Come on, Nintendo.
Mario Kart 8, when?
I forgot what I was gonna say. I really did like, though, that Springman the Assist Trophy literally got it and then got socked in the face. Ninjara had it in its mouth, and it hinted basically towards him being a Mii costume. Because he got the.
But, like, a lot of characters.
No, because he held the letter.
I mean, that's true.
So I thought that was a really neat twist, and then Min was finally got it. And it also showed, because they never show it anyways, they can transform their arms at will. Like, Sakurai was the first person to ever explain that to me, because
yeah,
I was wondering if it was their real arms or not.
I was like that.
That's what
I just thought in this world your arms were springs.
Yeah.
I was like, damn, Springman, hella boring.
No, they're
like,
just...
I'm learning. I'm like,
no,
oh,
they're
dude.
Just people...
Told you, it's just his YouTube channel.
So I need him to, like... do more stuff I'm into, like, more, so I can, like, I'm learning.
Kiseki.
Yeah, I'm like, thank
if
you.
If a Kiseki character came in,
yeah,
like, tune in for the 2.5-hour presentation, and it's like, this character can't be complicated. He goes, all right, guys, I just want to let you know, the character analysis is at 1 hour and 10 minutes. Everything before that, and then after 1 hour and 39 minutes, is a discussion on Kiseki series, so, skip around at your own discretion. Anyway, Kiseki...
What would you do if they announced it was from the Trail series?
No, like how there was arms.
Would we have like a billion hour discussion on who it is?
I don't think so, because there aren't that many options. But I would be extremely.
I don't know, man. There were people that kept thinking Springman was not gonna be an assist trophy.
I mean, yeah, but like, Kiseki has main characters. So it's only three.
That's true.
So
arms.
By the way,
exactly.
Do you guys see Alpharad's analysis, I guess, like, video on this?
No,
I think so.
When he was just, like, when they pointed to it, it's just, like, when they said that there were no main characters of ARMS, he was just like, yeah, because the main
character
is inside of you all along. And I'm just like,
both on Twitter,
this is so great. And also... he tweeted, apparently, like, really early in the morning. He's like, who's excited for the ARMS character? I'm just like,
he did.
I love you so much. I need your energy when Tencent announces their new Pokemon.
I need Alvarez's reaction of Pokemon Unite, because his sarcasm is a whole different level.
Yeah, he's great.
I don't know.
He has a series called Stage Builder Was a Mistake.
So,
do you remember, at one time it was like Dark Magician Girl's boobs?
Yeah.
The ID was, it's already been deleted.
Yeah.
And then it's like, name was, trust me, it's already been deleted.
Oh, he's so funny.
Or, remember in the Three Houses video, he's like, was it three? Oh, no, it was the Joker video. He's like, you're gonna choose Slifer Red. Slifer Red. Raw yellow or obelisk blue.
Yeah, like, oh, the picture with, like, him with the dual disc is so fucking funny.
Yeah, that was great. Oh, man. So, I wrote here... Oh, wait. So, I wrote here, Waluigi rant, check. Spirits don't confirm, check. Now we just have to talk about this. Geno's invoice confirmed. Already shipped.
Already confirmed.
Shipped. Smash X Geno.
Alright, how mad are you? Imagine if they're like, alright, well, we can't show off the character. We can't show the series they're from.
No, I guarantee you.
It's from Kirby. They'll be so mad.
I'm telling you right now, if they announce Mario, there are going to be so many people that are just like, it's going to be Waluigi versus Geno. When I'm going to be sitting here just be like, are you guys stupid? They're doing this to build up hype. It's going to be Paper Mario.
Yeah, that's true.
Paper Mario.
That's true.
Are you stupid?
You want a lot of pulls.
Yeah.
Like the Smash Ultimate.
Yeah, yeah, but I really hope. I don't want another Mario character, though. Because, like.
I'm
not paying for Mario. Like, I don't. No.
That's. Yeah, it would be stupid. Yeah. I would personally just put in Geno, but if they put in Paper Mario, I would still. I would still like it because I'm a Paper Mario fan. Well, I was a Paper Mario fan before, you know.
Paper Mario games.
Yeah. I am a fan of the real Paper Mario.
I'm not
Mario
against
games.
Geno or anything if he's interesting, but, like, I don't want another Mario.
He's gonna have a gun.
But he's Gun Mario. I'm kidding.
Yeah,
I'm kidding.
If he's really cool, I'd be down.
I think I would pee myself if they go, the character is from Mario and the Legend of the Seven Stars. Yes. Mallow!
And then just Geno me costume. And then
I'd be like, whoa! You're gonna get so much shit for that!
Oh, it'd be so funny.
I'm not gonna lie, I would die of laughter.
I honestly would, though.
I would love Geno, because I played that game, and he's my favorite character in that
game.
God,
no, that'd be so
funny. But I would start dying.
No, because I would love.
I would main Mallow.
I'm not gonna lie. As much as I want him, he is like he. As much as I want Geno,
Mallow.
Are you kidding me? Seeing the fan base.
Oh,
riot that it's. Hold on. First of all, the fan base that wants it to that would rather be Waluigi. The fan base that didn't want it to be Geno. And then the fan base that did want it to, or from Super Mario RPG, and then the fan
That's
base that wanted
everyone.
It to be Geno, I would die of laughter.
That you just described the entire Smash fan base. That
you know
covered
you
everybody.
Know why it's gonna be Mallow? Because think about it. What does Geno use? A gun.
Uh-huh.
What every special Mii character? It's always been a Mii gunner.
It's always been a Mii gunner.
So
oh
true.
No, Doom.
Anyways,
if he at least doesn't
have like the ass Mii costume he had in 4 and it actually looks good, I might be okay.
Yeah,
with
what if
it.
He was a Mii costume and he came with some music?
Yeah, you know, what would be really funny is if the picture of him leaked and they're like, he's in the game, but it's like the top of him. They're like, that's not the shitty Mii costume, and the Sakurai's like, yes, Mallow, and he's like, and. One more thing, they're like another DLC character. Geno
I don't think it's gonna happen. I think we're getting a Mallow Mii costume to get Geno.
No, but this would be funny.
No. It's gonna be fucking hilarious.
I almost want that to happen. I
don't think it will. However, Jack, you did talk about Horizon Zero Dawn. And Breath of the Wild being in the same
year.
Oh yeah.
So, Breath of the Wild. I mean, well, Horizon Zero Dawn has now been confirmed for 2021.
So if
Breath of the Wild's coming out next year,
yeah,
Nintendo's gonna be like, you thought we weren't doing anything with it?
No. I hope it does. Please.
I pray.
Wait, did Breath of the Wild come out? It came out first, right? And then Horizon, or was the other way around?
I think it was the other way around, right?
Came out like a week before. Horizon came out a week before.
Oh, okay. And then immediately got sucked.
Yeah, literally. Like, people were talking about it, Breath of the Wild came out, gone. It was,
you know what else came out? That thing.
Anyways, I said...
Oh, that's right. That's true.
Same day.
I wrote down after the Geno thing, trailer was dope, thank you Sakurai and team.
Thank you Sakurai, very
I'm
cool.
I'm looking forward to more of these.
For making the things look so good during these troubled times, because we know he was working on it during the virus. And
that was recorded May 2nd.
That it was.
And that was during the peak.
Well, here. In Japan, they didn't get as hard as we did, so.
I mean,
they actually did a good job dealing with it.
I always like it when he's like, oh, this is when it was recorded. Like, I think the Biophone, he's like, we recorded it, like, right after Thanksgiving.
Yeah,
you think about what you were doing, you're like, man, I had no fucking clue. No idea. And then, meanwhile, on the other side of the world, Sakurai and a team of, like, producers were like, baka! Now is the time to indulge.
LMAO, she looks great, and the stage looks fun. Might be broken, might be trash. I'm a player, though, when she comes out.
Apparently, top player so far, they're like, doesn't look that great, but we'll see. It's kind of the idea.
She looks fun.
No. They mean, like, competitive.
I know.
Yeah.
That's sad.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not a big fan. I mean, granted, I didn't see plays. I think she's cool. I think she totally deserves to be in. I'm gonna play her once. Go, I did it.
Yeah.
Go back to playing Shell.
Because especially because like he was like, oh, she's good against heavies and bad against fast, lightweight characters who are good in the air. I'm like every good character in this game. Like, what
fast,
were you
light,
thinking?
Good in the air. She's good against King K. Rool.
Yeah, basically. And it's like, I'm like,
all you K. Rool mains in December of 2018, so watch out.
I was like, what are we talking about? Like, Sonic Raid, no.
I mean, 2K18.
But, yeah.
And I only play Charizard.
Because, like, the thing is, when she extends her arm, like, all of the spring part is not a hitbox. So all you have to do is jump over the fist part, and then you're safe. And when it comes back, there's no hitbox. So it'll just, and then
you're
probably,
he's
know,
probably
like,
gonna buff that, so that way, like, at least when it's being pulled back and you get hit by it, you'd hope.
Yeah. Like, because all you'd have to do is jump over and hit her, and then you're in, and then.
Oh, sure, hot bars did it.
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, yo, Tipper, I see you, Sakurai. I see you.
With one hand.
That's right, with one hand.
What
well,
a
I
god.
See you. What a god, that's right.
Meanwhile, I'm out here shielding Mark's neutral beam.
Although the extent of
Sakurai's
the arms is pretty big.
He's tippering one-handed.
Wait, what?
The extent of the arms is pretty big, so if you pull it back enough,
yeah,
probably, like, just shield any, like, try the perfect shield.
Oh, that's great. You could shoot an arrow with Link on one side of the stage and then get just fucking punch you.
Unless it clanks, bro. That's like, bro, really.
Oh,
man. They could just like, I think we're back. Yeah, have you ever seen Bayonetta Dittos in Smash 4? They would just like shoot guns at each other.
Yeah.
Like, are you kidding me?
The last time Smash 4 was at Evo.
Oh, that was depressing.
It was Bayonetta.
See, on the pride side, though, Evo Japan had a grand finals of Zero Suit versus Sheik, which is just
interesting.
The coolest
not
thing.
Bayonetta.
Not just that, but because it's like that was one of the that matchup is one of the most storied matchups in all of Smash 4 because Nairo
and
Zero. So it's like that's just awesome. Like all like, the first 2 years of Smash 4 was just Zero Suit versus Sheik in the grand finals. It's awesome. I was like that's a better send off than what we got here.
Yeah,
like,
right.
That's a great send off.
Two people fucking holding the B button for
yeah.
2 minutes.
And like talking to each other. Like, yeah, come on, man.
Let's talk about Mii costumes. First of all, we got Ninjara.
Yeah.
Yay.
I didn't know that till 10 minutes ago.
Then we got Callie and Marie, who look absolutely awful.
Horrifying, dude. I was
horrifying.
Scared. I was like, this is terrifying. Oh my god.
Then we also got Heihachi, thank god.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, yeah.
Like, thank god, because I could not have standed 2 months of Bandai Namco speculation.
Yeah. What are we gonna...
Bamco.
They don't have... Like the thing is, like, we could say, like, oh, this character would be cool, or this character would be cool. They have, like, 3 franchises.
Yeah, but they have...
And the rest of them are anime.
Well, they have... They have one of the biggest JRPG series of all time.
And it would be cool if a character from there got in.
Wait, who are you talking about?
And it would be great if
JRPG
a character...
series?
Tales.
Oh, yeah, Tales,
yeah.
The way you went...
And also, not... But the sad truth is Fighter Pass 2, or DLC Pass 7...
Yikes.
Lloyd Irving.
Fine.
Lloyd Irving. Calling it right now.
No, I don't want Lloyd. Lloyd's boring.
No, as an assist trophy.
Oh.
I'm not as an assist trophy, as a Mii costume.
Oh.
And then that will cancel Tails out completely.
No, I want a character. Tails has so many cool characters. We could have Yuri, we could technically have Lloyd, we could have, Velvet. We could have Velvet, I don't care. Jude would be amazing, or Mila, or both.
The guy from Azure is gonna happen.
From what?
The guy
from Arise?
Arise.
Oh,
that
would be cool.
Azure.
I think I just want to watch AO.
Oh, Kiseki?
Yeah, Kiseki, because the Zero is
Azure. Yeah.
Azure is
Azure. Yeah.
Anyways.
Very excited.
The big one. Though, by the way.
Yeah. The weird one.
The Vault Boy.
Yeah. Like, what Nintendo? What are you smoking?
Oh, I know why. It's because the Fallout app is on the Switch.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Like,
but, like,
I guess.
Why? to build a relationship for Smash and Bethesda so that way Doom Guy could be in the game.
King was rich from the start.
Guys, it's happening.
Guess what? That's even deeper cut because that's a Fallout reference.
What?
The game was rigged from the start. I'm gonna have words if Doom Guy gets it. Anyone from the best gets
it. I'm telling you guys, that
Doom November, Guy should be me, Gunner.
That November leak of the Kako Mallow me costumes, real. 100%.
What were they?
So, Mallow had like a hat and like his vest thing, and it looked weird. And then Kako Demon had like a thing. So people were thinking that it was going to be Doom Guy and Geno revealed at E3.
That didn't happen.
Imagine. Obviously. So, well, I still think one of them is getting in.
But you want the right one.
Boy is in, Bethesda is in, fuck with friends for 10 minutes about Doom Guy.
No, you do. See, this is why he left.
No, I want more. I've kind of just come to the realization
that
Doom Guy is too gory in the first place, so it would just be better to get a Mii costume.
But I mean, Bayonetta also is not for kids either. Not even sexually, like. She, like, throws people...
Well, they throw religious, like, things in there that probably really should not be...
She throws people in Iron Maidens and shit.
Yeah.
She fucking...
That's
Nintendo,
true.
Nintendo doesn't worry about gore.
But, like...
They should put Mir in. They don't show anything in Mir. Aside from swords running through people. But that's about it.
They're also all robots.
Exactly.
And
there's robots that bleed.
Well, I mean, the
just
old...
like people...
But, you know.
I was wondering what happened to you. Thought you died.
I did.
So, yeah. So, Doom.
That would hurt.
He started talking about Doom Guy getting in. I said, this is why he left.
So, no, I'm telling you, man. Doom, the Kako Mallow Mii costume leak
is
real.
Who is Kako Mallow?
So, Kako Demon.
Who the fuck is Kako Demon?
From Doom?
Yeah, who is that?
The Kako Demon from Doom.
Again, I ask, who is the Kako Demon from Doom?
Hold on, I'll show you.
Sorry, I didn't ask the right question.
Yeah, who's John? You know John. Who is John? John. John is John.
From work. Who's John from
John?
Work?
He's best friends.
The Meatball.
Yes. The Meatball.
Oh.
That was shown as a meat head. And
what?
Then there was Mallow.
When? Oh, like
there was like a leak in November that nobody's been able to disprove or prove. So the thought is
no.
I was like, oh, we going in the rabbit hole when he said able to disprove, and then he said or prove. So I'm like, then it's a rumor.
No, that no one's able to disprove
or prove,
like,
or prove that it's fake.
But. Like, that the same.
Alright, but then if you're saying to disprove or prove that it's fake, that means disprove it's fake, meaning prove it's real.
Right.
Okay.
Or to prove that
nobody
it's fake.
Nobody has been able to show that they were the ones that made it.
So no one can confirm nor deny the legitimacy of the...
So it's... So the last time that happened was Ken.
That one was like... Like, that was bad though. That leak was...
How bad was it?
They just showed Ken. He was just there.
Yeah, so the last time this happened, by the way, yeah, was
people
Ken.
People thought it was fake, too.
People thought it was fake. And it's like, nope, that's just the picture.
That one was so funny.
I mean, Smash fans will want to not believe anything. They thought Shulk was Little Mac.
That's right. That's right. Oh, man, that Ken shit was so funny.
If you don't
want
to see it, you don't have to.
That's right.
So, yeah, essentially, that could be real. We just don't know.
I'd just like to point out, the Blizzard has upgraded from the laptop to the couch.
The white... No, hold on. Hold on. The white couch.
The white couch. With his controller and many wires.
Is that an upgrade, though? Because I feel like that's more dangerous. So it's like.
No, the upgrade is it being more dangerous.
No, because I feel like the Blizzard wants to, like, put things at risk.
That's what I'm saying. So
you know, the laptop would take all the frontal damage, but look at all the extra
that's
stuff.
That's true. That's, like, multiple
like
things.
Like, that's
plus
Kyle's
the
laptop.
Couch. That's true.
Okay.
But this is...
So anyways, Neil, I didn't tell you, but I have doubt Volpoy is in, Bethesda is in, fuck with friends for 10 minutes about Doom Guy.
You planned this.
I don't know, I'm Master Chief over Doom Guy, especially with Infinite coming out. So
that's hardly any
better.
What? So, alright, hold on. When did Halo 5 come out?
I don't know. But Halo 6 is coming out later this year.
Hold on, I want to do some research.
About what?
Hold on.
Doom came out 3 months ago.
Not Doom. This is about Halo.
Halo's last game was Halo Wars 2?
No, Halo 5.
Halo 5 came out in 2015.
Okay. Did anything come out in 2014 for Halo?
No, the game other than that. Well, there might have been Spartan Training in 2013 or 2012.
Okay. So anyway. In Smash 4,
yes.
That came out in 2014.
Uh-huh.
A year later,
yep.
Halo 5 came out.
Yep.
The logic you are giving to me now suggests that any time a Halo game is coming out, Master Chief is imminent.
Yeah.
Might I remind you, Halo's from like 2001.
Yeah.
Same year as Melee.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Alright, but hear me out. Halo isn't coming out till what? This year or next year?
This year.
Probably this year. No.
It can be revealed at the Game Awards.
But why is Halo coming out this year have anything to do with Master Chief getting in?
Well, whenever a game comes out, like a new game comes out, especially with like the Byleth stuff, the Corrin stuff, not ARMS,
well,
the Hero.
We know about that. That's not a new game. Dragon Quest XI is...
But they
it's
did
not
ridiculously
new. I don't care what
for
you
it.
Or Nintendo
they
thinks
They did
it's
ridiculously
not a new
advertising
game.
For that game, and you know it, and I know
they
it.
They advertised that game till the day it fucking came out because they really, really wanted to sell it.
Yeah.
Which makes me laugh because I was pretty certain that game was just going to sell on its own.
Yeah.
And then other shit, they'll just be like, talk about the DLC character a week before they come out.
You know what I'm saying? Square Enix has that money, so they can keep doing this.
So
Nintendo, more
keep advertising.
Right.
But the thing is like Microsoft has even more of that money.
Yeah, but they're also not on Nintendo. So
they're not on Nintendo's what?
They're not on no Halo's
not
on Nintendo anything. So. Why would they give them money to advertise their game for their system?
Cuphead,
like Nintendo, please.
Minecraft.
That none of
Minecraft
my counts.
Ori and the Blind Forest.
That I'm talking about Halo though.
Halo,
unless Halo
Master Chief
no,
Collection.
Unless Halo is coming to the fucking Switch, it's not happening.
So the Master Chief Collection has also been
is it on the Switch?
Has also been incredibly
you cannot prove a rumor
sources.
With a rumor. I refuse to allow you to do
okay,
this.
Okay, a leak.
The same shit.
But it was by a credible person.
I don't care. Until I see Master Chief on my Nintendo Switch.
Kyle, do you trust me?
No.
Damn. Do you trust Neil?
No.
Alright, who do you trust?
No one. I only
myself
trust myself.
Alright. Fuck you. I was gonna say something really funny. Alright. Do you trust that all men have one dick? That men are generally born with one?
No.
This isn't a yes or no question.
No,
this is
some
rhetoric.
Well, what if there's a birth defect that they're born with none?
Alright, let's broaden this thing. Do you agree that all humans must breathe air to survive? Again. Let me state again. This is not a yes or no opinion question.
Well,
this is a rhetorical question.
Well, I guess so.
So yes, okay. So I have logic. Thank you. You agree with me that all humans need a breather. If I came up to you and said I don't breathe air, I huff Cheeto dust to survive, would you go, well, I trust him, so he has to do that?
Yeah.
Kyle, you had 10 minutes to talk to us about Doom Guy, not Halo.
I had to fill the time somewhere. Anyways, the thing about Volt Boy is that I found really cool, because I mentioned it to you guys off camera, or I mentioned it on the verses we just recorded, was that Doom Guy, not Doom Guy, Volt Boy, my bad,
yeah,
was released on the 76th, with the 76th unique fighter.
Yeah, because of Fallout 76.
This is a Fallout 76. I thought it was very creative.
It's horrible.
So, yes, it is. I thought, so that means numbers could mean something to Sakurai. So on the seventh month of the seventh day of the seventh month, the legend of the seven stars could be number 77 as a me costume.
So we waited from January,
yes,
to now.
Yeah.
So that's 6 months. I get that a virus happened. So, alright, so instead, when did Terry come out? November?
I think so, yeah.
So
yeah,
November, right, to January, we waited from Terry to Violet.
It's not going to be revealed, obviously. It's just speculation people have been having.
I mean, that makes sense.
Because the 77th character being about the seven stars.
Yes, that
Gino,
would be.
It
I
would
mean,
make
he likes
the
numbers,
most sense.
I mean, this is how he teased three houses.
That's,
yeah,
funny.
So that
it's
was
not
the
17th game.
So
I don't know what planet
what
he
you
lives
mean?
On.
Heroes is a legitimate game.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
that's the best Fire Emblem game.
Pull for my life.
By the way, they apparently lost money. Not lost money, but they lost, like, I guess, increase in sales. So Nintendo's been backing off on phone games.
Yeah,
because,
yeah,
like...
And then Pokemon King.
And then people were just like...
Hello.
Dragalia lost.
Yeah.
It's not going to be in Smash anymore.
Wasn't ever.
Fuck you.
So yeah. I would like to go. So I guess going forward, let's talk about some speculation.
To be as a me costume, 9S gets it.
9S as the.
I mean, I would rather have 2B.
I'm not gonna lie. The way I see it is, I think it would be like a 2B me. Not a 2B me costume. My bad.
2B 9S costume.
So I think it'd be maybe like a 2B. Character with an A2 Echo. Or an A2 skin.
Yeah, she needs more skin.
Yeah.
And then, like,
the thing is, she has her rage mode.
That's, like, the only thing, though.
So I was thinking that would be her mechanic. That's why I think maybe A2 instead of 2B, because of the rage mechanic.
Yeah, but also, like, you can't run around. And, like, if that was, like, her final smash, or, like, oh, you mean, like, for just a normal moveset, not final smash.
Well, because most DLC characters have something that they, you know, like, have added to them.
Yeah, well, I mean, like, 2B also has the pawn.
Yeah, and, like, she's got other, like, cool stuff. Like, she can,
like, dash dodging and stuff.
Yeah, she technically has witch time, which, so, you know.
Except this one's gold instead of purple.
Exactly.
And she also makes, like, 3 of herself when she does it.
No, I mean, like, no, because, like, I think a pod thing has a thing where they can slow down time.
Ooh.
Just, like, a pod program. So.
Anyways, with speculation, we already mentioned that spirits are officially, the spirit rule, the fan speculated spirit rule is officially dead. That
yeah.
does it doesn't matter.
So what you're telling me is Lynn can be in the game.
No, she's my sister.
Oh, right.
Yeah. I can't help you there, buddy.
I shot him down so hard.
I can't help you there, buddy.
And
however,
don't worry, Zero can't either. He's also an assist trophy.
However, I would like...
Here.
Well, that one I'm going to say is... I already think anybody, because of the way he's talked about me costumes, I think they're already, like, confirmed, deconfirmed. Anybody who gets a a Sydney costume.
No, Rex.
So that means Rex. That would mean Altair, the Rabbids.
Oh, I can take that.
Yeah.
Any day. I don't like Rex. I'll take that.
The Mega Man characters that came back.
That hurt.
Heihachi. I have to make
Titan's
it hurt.
Boring.
There was a Battle Network person.
I know. Feels bad, bro. Because they have Mega Man.exe.
I can't help you.
Why do you do that? This one, right?
I guess Veronica from Dragon Quest XI, because she was a thing. Slime, because of the slime.
I'm not buying Dragon Quest XI.
Gosh.
Him and Nintendo, they got to.
Sonic, Tails. No, I mean Knuckles, Tails.
Sonic.
Yeah, right.
Please deconfirm Sonic. Yo,
put Sonic in the game, bro.
Put Sonic in Nintendo, please.
Yes. And, you and the guy from 3. Oh, and Morgana.
Minato and Morgana.
So they have all.
Good,
Morgana's
all you'll play timed. He's gonna play 2 minutes timed. He's gonna go.
Oh, yeah, and then the obvious ones, Cuphead and Sans.
They need to be in the game.
And, Vault Boy. So.
Vault Boy's final smash be he nukes the field and you watch all your friends get obliterated to nothing.
Yeah, and then the just nuclear radiation coming off the stage.
So.
It goes to white and then it opens on Skyrim. So.
So I would say. So I would like to say assist trophies because they're already programmed in the game with their models. And the problem I have with assist trophies is that it would take a while to program. If this character's on this stage, then they have to be this assist trophy can't appear, right?
Yeah.
It's gonna take hours of coding, maybe days,
maybe
weeks.
Days, but I feel like it's also pointless. Like, why even bother?
Like why bother at that point when you could just have a new character entirely? However, like changing a spirit thing would just be like, oh, if they have this, you could just change the spirit.
Or just
out.
Not because, like, again, fighters have spirits. Like, who cares?
No. But I'm just saying that's a very easy one because you only have to do it for that one spirit battle.
Plus, like, I feel like the reason that those characters were assist trophies are assist trophies because they were never supposed to be in the game in the first place.
Yeah.
So.
I just want to be in.
Yeah.
I know.
It'd be so cool.
I know,
like,
we're getting
City
to that.
Ruins.
No.
Like, Song of Ancients. Oh.
The
amusement
theme.
Park.
I guess
yeah.
Tangent. There is a
beautiful song.
There's a person that I subscribe to on YouTube that's been doing remixes.
Oh yeah.
For Nier. Like there were like 4 or 5 in a row. It was really cool.
Imagine if one of the tracks that Sakurai was like, one of my favorites is a track called Become As Gods. And you'll see what that means when you play the game.
And you'll see, yeah.
Every Nier fan.
Yeah.
Like, what?
Anyways. So yeah, like and then Mii costumes, yeah, you could just change the spirit battle and whatnot. But Sakurai very heavily talks about them as if they're in the game. At least, like, some of them, like the deluxe Mii costumes, such as Cuphead, Sans, and Vault Boy. Even though he's not, like, a deluxe Mii costume, he looks good. So I would like to say that Mii costumes as a trophy is deconfirmed. However, the spirit rule, I think, we can officially leave to die.
I mean, yeah, Min-Min broke the rule.
Min-Min has officially broken that
I
rule.
I think we can do that if Banjo broke the Japanese-only rule. Min-Min can break the spirit rule. I don't think we need, like, a, that was a fluke. If it happens twice, then...
It's now, and then people could say, oh, the only rule that he's ever mentioned is, like, the video game one, but it's, like, there has to be other restrictions, like, he has to be able to create a moveset, he has to be, or think of a fun moveset.
He also has to legally get the rights to
he has to, A, he has to be legally
that's
get
probably
the rights
the biggest
to
thing from anything, is probably that.
Which is why getting Sora would be a $2 billion waste.
I don't think he'd die.
Hold on. $1 billion for Mickey, $1 billion for the rest of them.
You just don't pay for Mickey.
Alright, Mickey is not worth $1 billion. You know how I know?
Disney thinks
because,
so.
Because Minecraft was bought for $2 billion by Microsoft.
Okay.
You need to tell me the block game is more expensive than the mouse.
All right, I'm sorry, you're right. $7 billion. $5 billion for the mouse, $2 billion
you
for the rest of Kingdom Hearts.
You forgot the infantillion.
I feel like Mickey isn't even like negotiable. Like,
there's just he's not for sale.
No, but the thing is, you have to have the mouse in Smash Bros. If you have Kingdom Hearts in there.
Me Gunner, Mickey, no me brawler. Mickey's gonna beat you.
Ha ha! I'm gonna shoot you. Ha ha!
Yeah, it's over. Disney's up your ass now.
Yeah,
sure. It's already there.
Oh!
They're like, that's $5 every time you uh-huh.
Hold on, I got you guys. I wanna go where the people are. Oh.
That's $10.
Exactly. Anyways.
The video gets immediately taken down. I didn't even post it yet.
It's flagged.
Flagged.
Walt Disney appears by Kyle and snaps his neck.
So, I guess going into some these lists, I have two possible lists, which is now speculation, because last time we did a Nintendo only list.
Okay.
So now, because Min Min isn't, she is our first female rep of the whole entire DLC.
You gotta count furries in all costumes.
What?
What furry did we have that was female?
What?
What furry? Violet.
A furry.
Yeah, that's what
was Banjo and Kazooie.
That's not. She wasn't a DLC character.
Oh no. Well, I mentioned DLC. I was about to mention we're not counting alts. Min Min is our first female character of the DLC,
that
and if we
is.
Don't count furries, or if we don't count she's the first human female character.
Well, what non? What character?
Of
Zoe.
All of Ultimate.
That doesn't count. It's
Which
not
is
a
Isabel.
Character.
No, I'm saying Isabel.
That
oh, you're talking about. I thought you were talking about
the whole entire game.
Yeah,
no, now I'm talking about the whole entire game.
Oh,
I just said that.
Okay.
I said if Ultimate as a whole.
Inkling's a girl.
That's right.
Her main costume.
Not alts.
No, but
no
the main.
Her
like,
on screen, she's the girl.
The character selects?
Oh,
yeah. It's the
boys
female
are the
all
costume.
Yeah.
Gender equality. You have it.
Damn it.
There's two now.
Damn it, I've been found out.
Two compared to like 9.
Anyways.
Yeah, right?
Because of
more than the child.
Because of the trend that has happened, we could talk about reps from different companies.
Daisy,
come on. You're right, Daisy. Holy shit!
How dare you forget about the most forgettable Mario character?
You're right. No, the most forgettable one's Waluigi.
Don't. All right. Like we all get you don't want him in, but don't disrespect the Wa that way.
Yeah.
He worked hard to be that weird. Just for you to say he's forgettable compared to Yellow Peach.
Yellow.
Orange Peach.
Orange Peach. Cousin to Pink Daisy.
Alright. So. We could talk about reps from companies that are already in Smash, different ones. Or we could talk about how the trend was last time, which was one Nintendo character, a couple from third parties already in Smash, and then a couple from ones that aren't already in Smash. We're just going to talk about because we could do the more interesting ones, which is either female only roster or Smash or Spirit only roster.
To be either one, to be.
So,
is everything.
So I have to actually tell you guys that To be's just a robot. Like they don't even have like penis or vagina.
Don't they?
They're Android, so I don't think so.
That's true.
Yeah, yeah, that's true.
And they're not living and they're robots, so 2B doesn't count.
2B is a girl.
No.
She is a girl.
No.
Mental.
No, Maggie's. I don't think so.
They refer to her as a her.
They do that.
No.
This is true.
I mean, at the end of the day, though.
9S wants to 4-letter word her.
That's
at the end of the day, though, it's like. She doesn't
Did you pull down their pants and see? I don't think so.
Yeah.
Nope.
Alright, I'm gonna hit you with this. We can neither confirm nor deny.
So,
that
I
they
mean,
do or don't.
Right.
No, you're not right. I'm right.
Oh, the other one, the credible weak, they haven't been able to prove or disprove.
How is it credible?
You can't prove or disprove that she so is a girl, therefore she isn't.
She is a girl.
It's just like the spirits. It's just like the spirits.
Kyle,
until
do you
proven
have
otherwise.
Alright, I'm gonna say something offensive here. Do you have boobs?
Yes.
Alright, well, normal boobs. You have boobs. 2B has a female physique. Alright, so you're saying 2B is a man?
No, I'm saying 2B.
You're saying 9S is a
no,
girl.
No, I'm saying 2B is non-binary. So she can't be a part of the female-only roster.
She is binary. She runs off of ones and zeros.
That's right. That.
No.
Yes.
Oh, so now you're saying you think you know how technology works.
Yeah, I do. And obviously she doesn't have anything. All right,
well, fuck you. You can't stop me, 2B.
Yeah. It talks
no.
now.
You're going to keep bitching about Doom Guy. 2B, girl roster.
No. And anyways, I have down for my first person as a female only roster, it's 2B.
You sexist, you won't let me put my favorite female character in a game, a strong, independent woman who doesn't need a man.
Alright, Kyle canceled confirmed.
Kyle canceled.
So I actually have down written down here 2B, fuck with friends that she's just a robot first. And then say it.
It's too late, you've been canceled already. Twitter knows everything.
Twitter knows, they're gonna pick up your old tweets.
Alright. Do we have anything else to say about 2B?
I feel like we've said it all already.
I think we've said it over the correlation of all
like,
of these videos.
Exactly.
Right. Secondly, that I have down because she's one of the most iconic females in all of video games, I put down Lara Croft.
I was going to say Estelle Bright, but I suppose you could technically, possibly, maybe argue that. That's fair.
I was really quick trying to come up with something funny. I was gonna be like, yeah, I was gonna go, yeah, Linkle.
Yeah, Linkle.
Nah, like, if you think about females in video games, you think about Lara Croft. At least in my opinion. Also Zelda, but Lara Croft.
That's true, that's who I go to.
Next up, I got Chun-Li from Street Fighter.
She'd be cool.
You know, okay, I'm sorry, but like, do you know who the first character is that shows up when you click JRPG protagonist in Google Images?
Please be a Estelle.
It's Estelle, right?
I love it.
That's great.
That's so good.
Hold on.
Estelle knows no bounds.
Wait, what is it? JRPG characters?
Just protagonist. That's what I did.
JRPG pro.
Hell, you don't have to. Yeah, you just go to Images. It's like Estelle. And then the third person, you got Adol there too. Only.
Oh my god!
I know.
I thought it was just because of your search history.
No. Oh.
Yeah, no, you're right. Even me, I've never looked it up. It's Estelle.
That's good.
Tell me she isn't iconic now.
Anyways, next up we have Estelle Ray. I didn't even write her down until you said it.
How did the guy from Xenogears get here before Shulk?
I love that.
That's so funny.
Anyways, well, Chun-Li is probably one of the most iconic, like, fighting females.
Yeah.
Oh, other than Mai, but she was proven that.
Yeah, Chun-Li.
But Mai now because Sakurai made her famous for not being for good boys and girls.
Only good boys and girls allowed in this game.
Next up is probably it's just something I've just heard under like the fake leak rumor mill because it was supposed to happen already anyways. Is Reimu from Toho. Because people have been wanting her as well.
They have? I mean I've definitely heard it
what?
A bit, but like Toho is a
Bullet Hell.
Gotcha. Oh, I
don't think
series.
She'd be likely, but I figured I'd put her in. And then me personally, as my last character that I put in originally, I put in Tifa Lockhart.
I would definitely die.
New
for
design
Tifa
Lockhart.
Just
we get
in
the
general.
Rest. We get the rest of the.
Tifa would be cool.
We would get more music for Final Fantasy VII.
Bro, I would literally trade my life for Tifa. Not
Ooh.
In Smash, just in general.
You know what, if Aerith came into Smash, you know what it should be? If you're close to someone, like, you're, like, standing near them, she, like, holds her hands, she looks up and smiles at them, Sephiroth comes down, runs the sword to ruin her, and then it runs through them, and then they both die.
Sephiroth! Oh my god. Anyways, I put down Ores just in case people hated my list. So, I put down or Breath of the Wild Zelda, or Urbrosa, or Mipho, or a new Zelda female. Breath of the Wild Zelda was someone I've actually seen speculated on because of Breath of the Wild 2.
She doesn't do it.
She only does stuff at... Hold on. I just have to say, she does absolutely nothing until the end.
Oh, she could throw a frog at you.
Yeah, and the only other thing that I could think of is the idea I had if she's in the background like a Pokemon trainer and she commands the, not the Divine Beast, the champions of Hyrule. Even though I think they'd just be a cool character in general.
She's like, stop following me. Throws a frog. Sakurai's like, her neutral beast throwing a frog.
That'd be funny. Well, we would have to see how Breath of the Wild... If she's even... First of all, she's playable, and second, if she's kidnapped.
That's true.
Oh, in 2.
Yeah.
You know she's gotta be.
We don't know, because there could be a possibility that you're just in this cave at the beginning, and then Link is the one that's taken away, and you play as Zelda.
That would be pretty cool.
That would be cool.
Because we don't know.
This Zelda is easily the most interesting...
Yeah,
well-developed Zelda we've ever had. So
she
please,
has such a personality.
Yeah, like, please let me have this character.
I grew to care about her so much.
Yeah.
If I was to have her in Smash, I would have just rather her have been just, like, her old costume just with... Or her new costume just with her... With the stuff that she has in the game now.
Wait, new costume and whose costume? Which
Breath of the Wild Zelda.
Oh.
I would have just preferred that over
like
taking up
thing.
A DLC slot.
Mm.
Still think we should have got Wild Link so we could have...
Well, hold on. Did you guys see the Joker amiibo? There's
a Joker amiibo.
Yeah, it looks so...
I like both of the amiibo, but I think that hero needs to be polished more.
Yeah, that one, I mean, like, it looks fine, but, like, Joker looks super stylish.
If it comes
like,
with a 4-pack, though, I'm so buying it.
Ooh, that one looks nice.
I know, I have to buy that one.
Anyways, the other three characters I have for an aura are Shantae, Cooking Mama, and Estelle Bray.
Which you just added.
Yeah,
all right,
that I
well.
Just added because I mentioned that.
Alright, well, I think we know who my pick is.
Cooking Mama?
Of course.
Yeah.
Iconic.
She is. She even had a game that was taken down off of the eShop because it burned a hole through your Switch.
It did.
It did.
Like a literal
no.
hole, but it overheated your Switch. It's hilarious.
Yeah, the hero one kind of looks weird.
I just hope they polish
they
it.
They should have had it where it was like all the hero. Okay, that's too many though.
The four pack of hero. I need it in my life.
Like it could have been like multiple heroes like coming like shooting out in different directions like with their sword.
That would have been cool.
That would have been cool, but there would have been too many, and I feel
exactly.
like the hero would have been too small.
Yeah. There's too many. There's only like 3 or 4 we could work with. It, like,
yeah.
All of it. That's it. You know how many were there? It's 4, yeah, they could have done that with 4 characters.
There's just, they each get one extra card.
Yeah. They're like,
yeah.
She could have just been, yeah, they could have done that.
Could have just made it a big amiibo where they're all, like, fighting together.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the next speculation list, which is the spirits. And I have to preference this from the base roster.
You're gonna have to help me out on this one. I don't care about spirits. So
there were spirits added for season 1. I feel like they don't have a chance.
Seasons? Yeah.
For DLC.
They're DLC
the season,
spirits?
No. Technically.
Hello.
What?
Really?
Yeah, the ones that come with the pack.
They come with the pack?
Oh, yeah, because I didn't.
Oh, you meant, like, oh, the. Oh,
hold on,
the
I'm not done. But there are also characters that just come in for spirit events that are free.
Uh-huh.
Like the actual chain, Pokemon, Resident Evil. I think those have zero chance.
Okay.
Like in this pass, because they were added during season 1 and not during the base game.
Right.
Which made my list very much harder for this. And a lot of these characters, I don't think are getting in, but I had to write them down anyways to speculate.
Correct.
The only one that I really think is getting in, which is on my base game, which is, of course, Geno. I think he's all at this point, because of everything that's been going on with the IP of the Legend of the Seven Stars, with having number 77 there, and with like the leaks, the trademarks, everything, and just everything going on, I think he's a lock. But that's my opinion. And I say that, and he'll just be a meme costume.
I agree on everything.
Me too.
I don't know who else are spirits though.
Second character I got is Shantae.
That'd be pretty cool.
I think that Shantae.
Starfighter.
I think that Shantae has a. It's like a 20. I'd say it's not that big. I'd say. I just think that we're only getting one other spirit, and it's going to be Chino, just because of the high request.
Right.
And that's going to be the end of our spirits list. Because my next character, who's as likely, if not a bit lesser, a bit more, is Rayman.
Oh yeah, he exists.
Because I put Gino on almost a 90, probably a 90, and I put Rayman from a range from like 85 to like, not 85, I'd say like, he could be a 50-50 to like a 90, to like an 100. Because,
that's an incredibly large range.
Because Ubisoft is just so friendly with Nintendo, why wouldn't they? But then again, they have spirits. They have they have Mii costumes. It could just be a chance that Rayman is just a Mii costume.
I know who's gonna come in. Crash. You know why? Because he's got a new game coming.
That was I think Crash is coming, but I just don't know when. I can see it though.
He'll be coming.
He'll be coming, alright.
He has a girlfriend. He'll come.
Really?
Coco.
Yeah, in the first one, he has a girlfriend named Coco. She disappears in the rest of this year.
For the rest of this year.
Did no one get my joke?
No, I don't.
I said he will be coming. He has a girlfriend.
Oh.
Yeah. And
oh,
then
I get it now.
And then we have. So
see,
yeah, that's
jokes
Rayman.
On you thought I was smart.
So originally here I had Rex and Pyra thinking, oh yeah, it's just like you can't have Rex or Pyra. Or you can't have Rex or Pyra because Rex is already a Mii costume. But then I thought about it and I'm just like, no, that's stupid. So I have to dig down deep because this is the replacement. The other one I just wrote down.
I was going to say, you can just get rid of Rex if you're trying to keep him for my sake.
No, I'm not.
Good, no one likes Rex.
I should put Elma here instead.
I feel
Anyways,
like people like her more.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyways, I wrote down here just because they got a new game. And I guess they have a good relationship with Nintendo. I wrote down Wonder Red because it was the only other character that I saw that might have an actual moveset. And I was not going to write down Bandana Waddle Dee.
Gonna write down Beautiful Joe.
Yeah. He's not a spirit.
No, I know. Oh, true, yeah.
I was thinking of the same person.
Yeah.
I mixed them up
a
lot.
So I was not going to write down Bandana Waddle Dee, even though he's probably even more likely. It's just that I just have a couple of characters that I'm against. Bandana Waddle Dee's one of them, and the other one's Waluigi.
Right. Like, who would be hyped for Bandana Waddle? Like, what is
there
that?
Oh, it's an orange bob with a spear.
Yeah, he's not even a character.
Game Explain.
I don't get it.
They all want him.
I don't
and
get
then they're
it.
Followers.
Because, like, I get Waluigi. He's an actual character. But I don't understand Bandana Waddle.
Because they want more Kirby
God.
Reps, and they don't know who to pick. Because Mark's already got
them. That's right.
That's Yo-Yo.
Alright, real quick, apparently Sonic Generations is $1 on Steam.
That's great.
That's a great
and then
Sonic,
Sonic Adventure 2 Battle is 74 cents.
So I have, too bad I have both
cares.
Of all both of them.
Oh,
Sonic well, Generations is good though.
Yeah.
But
bum,
Adventure
bum,
2 Battle
bum, bum,
is not.
No.
You can buy two Sonic games for the price of not even $2.
You know, that's a great
that's
ass
great.
Transition. Thank you. Because my last character is Eggman.
Oh, there we go.
Because I had to.
Silence!
I'm Dr. Robotnik. Tell me that he wouldn't be a hype character.
No, he'd be awesome. He'd probably have a really funny trailer.
He'd
too.
Be in his mech. He would probably have a trailer. Like, I would really hope that it went, like, it was the trailer where it was, like, done, 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 done. And then they would show, like, you know how they had the Banjo trailer or the King K trailer? And then instead and everybody thinks, oh, we're gonna get another Donkey Kong character or a rare character. The camera turns off and it just goes to where Sonic, what is it, the highway stage, Radical Highway from Sonic Adventure, and you just see Sonic speeding and everybody's just like, oh, Eggman!
I think it would be hilarious if they just made it in like Sonic Adventure 2, a really shitty mech gameplay segment. That janky animation, and it's just Tails gets it, and then Eggman hits him, and whenever you get a power up in that game, the camera pans around you, your feet glow, and it says, now gotten this. I would love it. Receive Smash Bros. Invitation, and then it cuts.
Another important thing is that the music has to be way louder than their voices. Like, I have to barely be able to hear them. That's a requirement.
Oh, also, BANNON! Also, by the way, they would add Infinite's theme for Eggman's when Eggman gets in the game.
is that song in?
No. I'm so sad. No, but they have the Sonic Forces actual theme in the game. I'm like, what is wrong with you?
Seriously. Wait, how did Infinite's theme go again?
I am the darkness. Darkness of
days. Oh, it's so cringy. Nobody is so good. This is
fortunate.
I remember it now.
It's so good.
One who thinks that I'm infinite. The one can turn to the one after that you can see. No, I don't know it.
I'm getting the Vietnam flashbacks from it now.
Alright, so, and those are my five spirits because god damn it, this game had like every other. Because I didn't want to pick a character from another franchise that I already mentioned, because my character I would have picked instead of Wonder Red would have been Paper Mario, but... Last thing. Sakurai at the end. God, I can't believe I'm saying this. He said, we'll at least give you five... God, this man deserves a break.
Okay.
How do you guys feel about a third season? Is it happening?
It isn't happening. I don't want it to happen.
That's why I need to say fucking money, man. At that point, I could have just bought a different Smash game.
But is it?
I don't think.
Do you think it's gonna happen?
No.
No.
No. I don't want it to happen.
I think, like, Nintendo's getting... I feel like the way they work with DLC is... Smash was, like, them sticking their toe in the water. That was when they were like, I don't know about it. And then they were like, alright, clearly DLC works. So, like, all their main stuff was like, alright, we're gonna give you one expansion pass. That's all you have. And then they were like, well, did you know that other game companies have... Nintendo was like... Don't they get mad? Don't they get mad if you charge them for more? And they go, yeah. And they buy it anyway. Alright. Smash. I don't want to do it. Two seasons. I don't want to do it. And then, like, the next Smash will come out. And then we'll get we'll get multiple seasons.
Yeah,
and then they'll... What's another DLC practice other than multiple expansion passes?
Costumes, I guess.
Yeah, but that, like, falls in with,
well,
like...
Well, I was
going to
say
microtransactions. Maybe that, but that's,
like most
not...
fighting games don't do microtransactions, though.
They don't.
Like, something in DLC. Is there another DLC pack?
Like, just
stages?
Just stages,
yeah,
exclusively.
Just stages.
The only other thing that I can think of...
Well, no, I'm talking about,
fighting,
like,
games do?
Like, broad things. Like,
that's
kind of
it for fighting games, though.
No, I mean, like,
well,
just
I remember
DLC
Tekken
general,
was
like,
talking about, like, new mechanics
passes.
or something else.
Yeah, but that's usually not DLC. Usually new mechanics are just a free update for the game.
Yeah, like, that's... I mean, I guess, like, new modes would be the only other thing that I can think of that a DLC would give.
That's true.
Yeah.
So, like, I guess maybe they'll be like, alright. Oh, I got one. They'll be like, alright, we're gonna have the expansion pass, which lets you get, like, the main DLC, and then we're gonna have the extra expansion pass one, which gets you stuff like stages and game modes.
Yeah.
And they're gonna be like, Smash, you can do that. And it's gonna be, like, $20 for the fighter pass, and then, like, $10 for, like, this one, and be like, it's $30. It's like, I had to buy three different things to get all of Smash, and it's like, all right, but there'll be a fighter pass, and then the extra fighter pass
extra
one,
fighter
and then
that.
Fighter pass two,
I
and then extra
that
fighter
that
pass.
We never get to that point.
So my thought is, as long as people buy the DLC,
which they will,
as long as the Switch is being produced,
which it will,
as long as Smash Ultimate is a thing,
which it is,
I think we're gonna get more seasons. As sad as it is to say, because I've changed my stance of I want it and I don't care like how it's done from 4. And like kind of base Ultimate,
he deserves a break.
He deserves a break. My hope is what I said when we were originally talking about season 2 in the first place. Is Sakurai will at least get a year before he has to work on season 3. Because I think that he deserves it, and I think that he deserves more than that.
I have a proposition about what season 3 could do to Smash.
What?
It's not going to make it special anymore. Think about it. If we keep getting DLC and then it's like we go 1 year with like nothing, they're like, that's it, no more DLC, and then like say like 2024 goes by and we get nothing. Then the beginning of 2025, they go, the end of this year, getting Smash 6. Is it really special anymore?
Like the problem that there is that, well, at least in my opinion, about a new Smash game, and I've mentioned this before, is nothing will ever feel as special as everyone is here.
Exactly.
So the problem that I have is that it's just...
But, I mean, do you also want to take away the only thing Smash 6 could have going for itself? It's been so long since we've had Smash.
Yeah, because, like, exactly.
Think about it, from Brawl... Exactly. Like, granted, I think Ultimate's great. It's my favorite one. And, granted, I was very hyped for Ultimate. Nowhere near as hyped waiting from Brawl to 4, because it had been, what, like, 8 years? 6 years.
6 years.
It was a crazy amount of time waiting. From Smash 4 to Ultimate, that's like 4 year wait, and we had like a year's worth of DLC, so it was like 3 years, and it's like, I don't know if you guys got the same feeling with Ultimate, like when it came out and like all the Ultimate content was out, you're like, this is deja vu. I feel like I'm back in 2014 when Smash 4 came out. Because like now everyone's talking about Smash and like learning all like the cool Easter eggs, like remember when you played Smash 4, you're like, oh, if you play with Toon Link on the Toon Link stage, then the train driver switches and stuff like that. You're like, damn, wow, that's crazy, they came out so close to each other. Then this is our second year of DLC. Or, well, first year, because, say, all of 2019 was its first year. Which means it's round, and this is its first year of DLC. It's like, it keeps going. It's not going to be special anymore. And, yeah, nothing is as special as everyone's here. And I do understand and agree with the mentality, might as well get everyone in while you can. But,
so,
if you only had a year, year and a half, 2 year wait between this and Smash 6... It's going to be not everyone's in here, and here you go,
well,
you play this.
My thought is that you could just do what GTA 5 is doing, you could just do what Mario Kart 8 did, you could just do whatever, and you could just make port over from Smash Ultimate to the Switch to the Switch 2.
I mean,
and
I would prefer that, but...
And Sakurai wouldn't have to slave away at a new game, he would just be working on a new fighter every now and again. Which would be definitely easier to do.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, but I don't think Nintendo would do something like that. Like, if they're gonna, if they're one of their big IPs, like, they're gonna make a new game. They're not just gonna keep porting their
own
one. Like, that's not
something. The problem is where's Mario Kart 9?
But they just re-released, or like the deluxe
that
edition.
That was 3 years ago.
Yeah,
and then that's
a 6-year-old game.
And that's a 6-year-old game. The problem.
How often do Mario Kart games even come out?
Sometimes they had this long of a delay.
Normally 3 years.
Really?
Well, I thought between 64 and Double Dash there was like a 5-year wait. Yeah.
It might have been, but like.
Because it's also like, it makes sense for Mario Kart because it has so many games, they've done so many different things with Mario Kart, that it makes sense that it takes them longer to come up with new stuff. Especially since like 7 and 8 didn't come out that far apart from each other. And they're both really similar games. Whereas, like, Smash takes a long time, so it's, like, it's always different mechanics and stuff.
Kind of. So if we pull up the Mario Kart Wikipedia. Okay. Mario Kart, Super Mario Kart came out in 1992. In 1995, Virtual Boy Mario Kart was supposed to come out. However, they canceled it, and Mario Kart 64 was from... was in 1996, so 4 years. You were right.
No, no, it was 5 years, but it was for Super Circuit.
It was 5 years for Super Circuit, and then 2 years later was Double Dash. 2 years after that was DS. 3 years later was Mario Kart Wii. 3 years later was Mario Kart 7. 3 years was Mario Kart 8. And then 3 years was Deluxe, if you want to count that.
And then 3 years.
Which I don't.
After that,
DVD. Because, like, most fighting games last for, like, near, like, for, like, 6, 7, 8 years or something. Like, they last a long time. Like,
so,
like, Blazblue Central Fiction, I think, came out, like, 2015, I think. It's now 2020. So it's, like, 6 years. Or five
and
years.
I don't, and Nintendo knows what they have with Ultimate.
And
that's
still not.
My thing is, Nintendo knows what they have with Ultimate. This isn't just a game that ends.
Yeah, I mean,
this is a game like an Animal Crossing, like a Mario Kart, like stuff that does not have an end to it that you could just play.
Yeah, but like, I mean, also Smash development's a lot more costly, like both in time.
And the
and
thing
in
is,
money.
Is that Sakurai has stated in interviews that he'll do stuff that make the fan like he'll do stuff like if the fans want more characters in this game, I want more characters in this game because it's everybody is here. And who knows when we're going to do that again.
If ever.
Probably.
If ever.
The
probably
poor man,
never.
It always hurts whenever I forget which trailer it is, but whenever I see it, when he just goes...
Yeah, that...
I wonder if I'll ever get to take a break.
I know, bro.
It
feels, hurts so much,
it,
and then you're like, oh.
He finished 4 and then went straight to Ultimate. Like, that
he
is
did
trash.
Not get a break.
That's
it
not fun.
It hurts.
I want him to make other games, not fucking Smash Bros.
He made Kid Icarus Surprising. That game was amazing.
Yeah.
Make a new thing. Not
but
even Kid Icarus.
But he said...
He should make Metroid.
Yeah.
I believe in Retroid Studios.
Yeah, but I also believe
in
Sakurai.
Where's the game?
Where's the
game? I'm not
sure.
I
they've had 2 years since they restarted the fucking thing.
That's right.
Where is it?
So, all I'm saying is, I'm just... Like, from a business point, why would you stop Ultimate when it is... Not only the best-selling fighting game ever, it is one of the best-selling games on the Switch, period.
Oh, yeah, you don't stop.
But I feel like if all
the
they kind of... Because look at, like, Mario Kart is, like, the best-selling game on the Switch, and they're not making any... They don't give a shit about making new content for it, clearly. So it's like...
They're like, a re-release of a Wii U game.
But the
is
thing is,
Switch
like,
game. Nothing.
Nothing.
But
like,
the thing is, this the
oh
Mario Kart
God.
Team also works on other stuff. I don't remember if it's Animal Crossing or Splatoon, but they work on
no,
that
but, like, but
as well.
If
Sakurai's team doesn't work on anything other than Smash.
I mean, but like, if they care that much about just the money, they would be like, no, you work on Mario Kart.
But they
need
found,
to make more money.
But they found DLC that works. Like they paid so much money. For this DLC.
I mean, technically, we paid $60 DLC to get Mario Kart Deluxe.
Sure.
To get Battle Mode.
Literally.
Battle
fucking
mode.
Battle
and
Mode.
And King Boo. And Double Items.
Yeah.
And Double Dash and stuff.
But he... But the thing is the team works on it still. The like the Mario Kart team ended up working on Splatoon, or started working on Animal Crossing, or whatever they still... Whatever they worked on other than Mario Kart... And maybe, hell, they are making Mario Kart 9, and I am just stupid and don't know. And that's why there hasn't been anything, but for Smash Ultimate, it's gonna be the only Smash game on the Switch. As far as we know, there is a chance that it could just be ported to the next console.
We forgot about a mainline Mario Kart game, guys. Mario Kart Tour.
That's right.
Remember, mobile games are mainline.
That's right. That's already
Heroes is a real vibrant
I'm pretty
game.
Sure that was developed by a different company anyway. Anyways,
games are real, guys.
All I'm saying is that Nintendo could feel a lot different about Smash because A, it's not even an in-house, you know, like in-house thing. If Sora Unlimited still wants to make content
and Bandai
for
Namco. Both of them, like,
Sora Unlimited and Bandai Namco,
yeah,
who clearly are Nintendo's bitches after taking Pokemon Snap,
yeah, that
are still
Bandai Namco, right?
Yeah, and
that's
who are still gonna do it? Which, by the way, can I go on a tangent for a bit?
Sure.
There is
on brand.
Yeah, there is a bit of a there's a rumor going around.
Yeah,
they will work on. They are gonna work on the technical side of the next Pokemon. No,
yeah,
it's not Diamond and Pearl. I'm talking about Generation 9.
Cool.
So, yeah.
I mean, so long as Game Freak and Pokemon Company touch it, I don't trust it. They've lost my...
It's gonna be shit.
After what got announced today, I've learned, I'm like, you know what?
I love that, dude.
That's
just not
even
expect
Game
anything.
Freak.
I'm just done expecting things from Pokemon.
Yeah. Because it's not Pokemon brand, so... They're all. They have their hands in the pie.
When they were like, "This is a team strategy game," I was like, "It's a good thing they put team, because if they had the audacity to say this is the first Pokemon strategy game, people would have been like, do you not remember Conquest?"
So all I'm saying is
also made like Pokemon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All I'm saying is that.
You can't just be like, I'm gonna buy a pack and play that. You have to learn.
Yeah, all I'm saying is there's a big possibility, as much as we want Sakurai to take a break, there's a possibility, even if it is just one or two characters, or three or four, or not even as much characters in the next pass, there's a possibility they'll just keep coming up with passes because they keep selling. Because they keep having these characters that people have wanted for such a long time.
That's true. I think if Nintendo's going to go down that route, they'll just keep doing it until the Switch gets replaced.
Yeah.
And then they'll just make a new Smash.
And even if they don't do that, there is always the possibility of a deluxe or a porter that just allows them to just create the next game.
I mean, I don't think they would make DLC for a port. They clearly wouldn't do it with Mario Kart.
It's true, but...
And that game sells very well. If your best-selling Switch game is a Wii U game, why wouldn't you? And I get
I'm shocked that they would work on a Mario Kart 9 when this game clearly is your best-seller on the Switch.
You know, the thing is, like, Smash is such a weird play. Like, the more third-party characters they put in the game, the less, like...
likely it is for them to get.
Or no, it's just like for the next game, like, they probably won't be there. So if they have, like, all third parties, those are all characters who God knows if they'll ever be here or not. It's like,
and
it's
not
like,
only
are you a
that,
third party?
But it's like, the more characters that there are in Smash, it's like, are we really gonna add Pichu again? Are we really gonna have this many Links? Are we really gonna have Dr. Mario?
But I feel like people aren't so super, they don't really care about those characters.
No, what I'm saying is, like, that's also a possibility, too. Do we really need all of these Fire Emblem characters if we're not going to have everybody is here?
By Crom.
Yeah, but I feel like more people are worried about third parties than, like, Echoes and clones and stuff. Like they're like,
they're
just
which,
that
which
have
again,
one
it's like,
yeah,
like
it's like,
back.
Let's just say,
well,
let's just
party,
say hypothetically,
say
Estelle goes in the Smash 6 instead of Ultimate, right?
Yeah.
Let's go with a hypothetical. Wouldn't it be cooler to say it's Estelle versus Marth versus Hero versus Joker instead of Estelle versus Marth?
I mean, yeah.
I mean, sure, yeah, but...
So...
What's your point?
My point is, like, I don't know if Sakurai really wants to make another Smash game if he can't deliver on Everybody Is Here, because... To him, it's like, before, Smash Bros. Wasn't about, like, it was we could only get Nintendo for the first two games. It's just Nintendo properties. Then it's like, Konami wanted Snake in Smash, and they decided, hey, let's put Sonic in Smash. And then there was Pac-Man and Mega Man, and other stuff, and then, like now it's become this giant video game mecca that, like, this is the representation of the history of video games that, like, you can't do if other things are gone. So to me, what I would rather have happen is this is it for Smash Ultimate on the Switch, and then on the next console, you find out, psych, Smash Ultimate Deluxe comes with, like, these characters, and we're gonna do more DLC, and then, you know, like, I would rather just have that over...
Yeah, I agree. I just think, like,
over a new game, because...
I feel like, yeah, whenever we get a Deluxe Ultimate or whatever, that's, like, a different story, but, like, currently, like, I don't know if we need...
I think it should just be Season 2, and
yeah,
that's the end.
I agree, and then just let the game rest for a while, and then if we get a port on the new Switch or whatever, then I'd be down for more characters. But, like, right now, like, I think we should let... Ultimate needs the time to breathe. Also,
yeah, like,
Sakurai needs the time.
I'm getting kind of smashed out. I'm, like, I'm kind of excited for, like, the second pack to end. I'm like, okay, good.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not excited for the second pass. I'm excited to see who's gonna be in.
Well, no, I'm excited to, like, for it to go on, but I'm also, like, you know, I'll look forward to the day where I'm like, and there it is.
Yeah.
The game's done.
That's everything
they wanted to make.
A huge reason as to why I don't want any more season passes, because I'm like, I kind of just want to be
like,
this is the game.
Another thing, too, like, the Fire Emblem expansion pass that came out in waves. When Wave 4 came out, I was like, it's done.
Yeah.
They made it. Or the Xenoblade pass. It's like, it's over. The game's done. They made it. This is everything I get for it. And then you can just play it, and then you don't have to be like, well, what's coming? There's solace in just letting something be done. Because that's what video games are. They're done.
There's also intrigue into who the fuck is the next character going to be.
Yeah.
Which I think
it gets kind of tiring. It's just
which,
like,
I think for, like, a lot of people gets to be very tiring.
Especially if it's someone you don't like.
I mean, I
don't care about ARMS, so, like, the whole, like, wave of, like, oh, Smash is cool,
like,
and, like, all the hype of it, I'm like...
Dude, that was literally me, like, the entire first pass, too. I didn't care for any of the characters, so I was just like, this sucks.
I feel like a lot of the characters that, like, I feel like we've all wanted are kind of in.
I mean, like, for me, like, there are plenty of characters that aren't in that I would want, but, like, they're not gonna get in, so I'm like, I don't really care about anything. I'm just giving you my money because... I have to give you my money. That's it.
That's another reason why it's tiring. Feeling to give money.
That's,
like,
yeah.
Because you're like, everyone's here, I gotta play.
Yeah.
I gotta get
basically
all the expansion pass, and you're like,
which
well,
is
I'm not
probably,
even yeah.
Which is probably why Nintendo wanted to continue DLC in the first place, because they're just like,
everyone,
are you guys really gonna be able to, would you guys ever be able to do Everybody Is Here again? And they would probably be like, no, probably
I
not.
Bet you another reason why they did the second pass, they go, so Sakurai, you know how you told them not to buy it unless they were sure? Well, they all fucking bought it, so...
Yeah.
I think we can do that again.
Like, literally, like, if it wasn't Smash Brothers, it was any other game, I would not buy any of the DLC. Just
exactly.
Like, unless your name was Joker or Byleth, it wouldn't have happened. And even... Oh, I see Hero. Probably wouldn't have happened. And even then, I'd be like, eh, maybe. I'd think about it. I'd be like, probably not. Because, like, I've played other fighting games. I don't care about any of those DLC characters.
I just want
to... Smash Brothers.
Same, even for, like, Injustice, I only bought the characters I liked.
Yeah, that's literally all I did.
I was like, fuck that. I'm not buying the Ninja Turtles.
Yeah, like, for Cross Tag, there's, like, one DLC character, I bought that DLC, and then that's it. I don't care.
I want to end off with, something, because, this is my own personal opinion at this point, and Alpharad said it best. He said, as long, pretty much, this is a whole pipe dream. Like, we got so many characters that are like, so cool in this game. Castlevania, Ridley, King K. Hell, Incineroar was cool. We got Joker. We got Banjo. Hero's fun.
Yo, he's, like, the funnest one.
He's the best.
He's so fun.
He's so dumb. I love it.
Yeah. And we got the soundtrack... Terry's inclusion is cool, and the soundtrack is cool, and then the ARMS character looks fun. And that's how I want to say is, like, he said at the end of the day, as long as the character is fun, that's all I kind of really care about. I'm going to buy whatever it is, and as long as the character isn't complete ass, I'm down for it. Like, Byleth didn't look fun to me. Do I think, have I played them since? Yeah. Do I think they're fun? They're okay. They're not, like, hero fun, because you could fuck with everyone.
Nothing's hero fun.
Hero was the only time when I saw the DLC, I was like, that character looks fun. I can blow myself
like,
up. Oh my fucking
you
god.
I could say,
are you kidding me?
I could say something about each of the DLC characters. Like, so as of right now, Joker was a character that I said that I really didn't expect, that I was laughed at about it.
Yeah.
By the two
we got
of you.
Proved wrong hard.
And he came in and getting that,
god, that
getting
was
that
so
when
funny.
I wanted him a lot.
Which is funny, he
was
didn't even
awesome.
Beat the game.
Yeah, at that time.
We're the ones
hero
the Persona fans. And we're like, he's not getting fucking in. And
being
meanwhile,
turned
the
into a Dragon Quest
god,
fan because of Smash
yeah.
was probably one of the funnest experiences I've ever had.
I remember dying because you that character lived and died by its soundtrack to you.
Yeah. He was like, if it has three tracks, I'm done.
I remember us so sitting funny. At the diner by your college, and you're like, if he doesn't have this many songs, I'm going to be pissed. And we were like, that's it. That's what's
that's
holding you
yeah.
back.
And then you played the actual game, and you're like, this is amazing.
It's such a good
it's
game.
So funny.
Banjo
that,
was...
If that game didn't have more than, what was
two
your...
Two tracks, I was going to buy it.
Yeah.
And then you would have never played the actual game, and then...
I
never
love
think
Dragon
about
Quest
off
11.
Of think
a sample
that.
Amount of tracks
yeah.
in a fighting game.
Yeah.
You would not have played with probably one of, maybe one of your favorite games.
That's
of all
like
time.
Me
That's...
being like, well, Tragic Decision isn't in Xenoblade stage, so I'm never going to play Xenoblade.
Yeah,
which
I'm never
isn't,
playing
and
Xenoblade.
It
yeah, I'm never
no,
playing
I know
Xenoblade.
You watched it because you're smart because you didn't want to play it. And I respect that because you still have experience.
Yeah.
Still...
So Banjo was fun because everybody wanted him, and being on that ride was really cool to finally see him be in, especially the way he was revealed.
Can't relate.
Was
yeah,
awesome.
Same.
I
actually got mad when that
also,
happened.
Also,
I was like,
seeing,
I don't fucking...
Hold on.
I've never
also,
been so...
seeing both of your faces when Banjo was revealed had to be one of the best things ever.
Bro, I've never been so apathetic about a Smash character since Banjo.
The worst part was I saw it coming a million miles away. I was like...
Yeah.
The rule that
apathy,
you guys loved so much died.
It was sacred.
No, dude, like, literally, my apathy knew no bounds. I just couldn't care. And then when I played it, I was like,
you know why?
Fucking
it's
trash.
It's because I was so happy because I thought the only thing we were gonna get was Hero. So I was rolling in the beginning. I was like, oh my god, we got Hero. I was like, Kyle, you hated the idea of Hero, and then we got Banjo, and
I was like, god fucking damn it.
I was like, ugh.
And then we got the reveal of Zelda.
Cares what?
Oh, yeah, Breath of the Wild, and I was like, oh, thank god, they ended it on something cool.
Yeah.
Terry's trailer was really cool, as much as I was like, oh, this probably shouldn't happen in the beginning.
I was originally really mad about him. I was like, is Terry Bogard,
and then I saw how much Sakurai cared about Terry, how much he was able to get from SNK had to be his dream, and I couldn't like, and you can't like ever say no, because as someone who is going into that business myself, because that's what my major is, that's cool.
When I saw Terry have 50 tracks, I was like, this is Kyle's favorite character.
Yeah.
It is. It really is. And then
he's not disproving
having
it.
The rage that was Byleth,
dude,
and
you were pissed.
And because even when Hero was revealed, you saw a smirk on my face.
This is true. You were
like happy. I was happy he was revealed. I had sheer hate for
you
Byleth.
So funny.
Mad.
Yeah, and dude. I was mauled. And to experience to have
he was mauled.
Mauled by who? By what? What?
Who mauled you?
Yeah.
The Smash
no,
hates
you know,
Byleth.
No, mauled,
they're on your side.
Mauled
right.
is a term meaning like mad and mad. Like
that's
you're so
mauled.
Mad that you're balding. It's like it's a lingo on Twitch.
Another
I've never heard that way.
What was the other one you said? No what?
No Maggie's.
No Maggie's.
I've never heard it.
Mauled. Mauled usually means getting like ripped apart,
yeah, yeah,
like
yeah.
eaten by like a bear and
yeah,
shit.
That's what mauled actually means.
I was like, I was
Mad
really
what Twitch chat. I've been in dozens of Twitch chats. I've never seen this in my life.
You know what he's like? He's like, he covers the mic. He goes, guys, seriously, don't call me out like this on the Mixer. I can't fucking give me.
Well, that would be hilarious.
The Twitch channel just
Mixer
facade.
Was bought by Facebook Gaming.
Yeah, Mixer's dead now. Like,
yeah. That's hilarious.
Facebook owns Mixer.
Yeah.
Yikes. Oh, yeah,
so,
is Ninja a free agent now?
Technically, I guess. He'll go back to Twitch.
Probably. He's going to be on Facebook Gaming. Or maybe he might just go to YouTube.
Alright.
So,
yes, just please read the title of this video.
Competitive stall cancer. Links meta, please.
Competitive stall cancer.
So to be able to experience so much joy and then so much hate and so many different emotions, and then also like with season one and then season two, for me just to be like, all right, I'm gonna go into this arms thing with smiles, because you guys. It's not even like I'm a closet ARMS fan. You guys know I like ARMS except for the gameplay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like, the music track I've been boasting about for years.
I
the characters are amazing.
It just feels wrong to be like, I like
the
game.
I love this game, but the gameplay is dog shit.
I know! It feels so wrong, but
like,
it's so right.
But like, I don't get it, man. Like, I feel like you can hate everything else except, you can't,
the gameplay is like what you need. Like,
yeah, because it's a video game. Like, if it was a movie,
so you don't like ARMS. You want to like ARMS.
Yes!
Yeah,
I want to like ARMS, but I don't like ARMS.
That's like saying I love Overwatch, but I can't stand competitive shooters.
Oh my god, me.
You're like, I love the Overwatch comics.
Me. Anyways.
Which
I
unironically used to love.
Yeah, and I love, and everything about Min Min, from the track to how she plays in Smash, to the Mii costumes, to the trailer, has made me really, I cannot wait for these next five fighters. And even if it's someone who, I have five characters, who if they are revealed into this game, I will literally be even more mad than Byleth.
They're all fire.
They are not all fire. None of them are Fire Emblem
Wasn't
characters.
This video about
Nothing
Min-Min?
Would make me more
this
mad
was.
Than another Avatar
we
character from Fire Emblem.
Well, no, it became a Min Min into like spirit speculation.
Anyways,
right, into Smash in general.
Yeah.
Anyways,
7 o'clock.
I know.
Oh my god.
Anyways, my characters are Waluigi, Steve from Minecraft, and I forget my other three.
Yeah, I want them too.
No.
I know these are the ones you
these
don't
are
want,
my,
but I
these
try
are
to
my
make
characters.
Mad.
Jonesy from Fortnite.
Alright, never mind. I rescind my statement. I would actually rather delete Smash than
Although I do have to say, Jonesy from Fortnite, I guarantee you will be a Mii costume.
I was gonna
and
say
And I accept that wholeheartedly.
I thought he was gonna say, not gonna lie, he'd be kinda cool though. I'd be like, cool, we're just not friends anymore.
Yeah.
No! I was just gonna say he would be a Mii costume. I think so. Fortnite's so big, and it was like the battle royale genre to have that represented in Smash. I think it's happening.
I mean, anyway. So who are your other characters?
Oh fuck! Who are the other two characters? I don't know. I just thought of like one character that I would just be mad about. It's not Fire Emblem. Waluigi, Steve from Minecraft, Jonesy, Jack's phone. I know. I don't remember. There are five characters. All I know is there are five characters that they are announced. I'm going to be mauled.
Again.
So, if I think of them, I'll let you guys know. But, you guys have enjoyed this almost 2-hour conversation that was only supposed to last 45 minutes.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah,
part of me knew it was a lie.
Yeah.
Yeah, but like,
you know what? We haven't even had a 2-hour wait on what we want for dinner.
And that's right, because we haven't even talked about it.
I'm hungry.
Yeah.
I know, me too.
Because all I had was that cheese and cookie.
Yeah, same. All I had was ice cream.
And,
Alright, leave a rate, comment, and subscribe.
If you guys
follow our Facebook page,
just let us know what females or spirits you guys want in the game, and why my characters that I don't want are wrong or right. Actually, if it's anybody but Waluigi, I'll listen to you. But if you say Waluigi has to be in the game, I won't take it. Like, I won't be as upset as and I'm only upset because Sakurai put in work for an assist trophy to be in.
Wasn't this the ending of the video?
I know.
Yeah.
I know.
Give me another hour.
I know. I just want to get this out there. I'd only be upset.
You got it out there
like
an hour ago. We know you don't want Waluigi, and we know why.
But Steven Jonesy
doesn't the video.
And we'll talk to you guys in the next one.
Rate, comment, and subscribe.
Doesn't.
Goodbye.